We want to find the integral of the quantity 4x plus 5 divided by the quantity x squared plus 4. In its current form though, none of our integration formulas seem to apply, but because we have a sum in the numerator here, we can write this as a sum of two different integrals. This is equal to the integral of 4x divided by the quantity x squared plus 4 plus the integral of 5 divided by the quantity x squared plus 4. Now for the next step, let's go ahead and factor out the 4 and factor out the 5. So we'd have 4 times the integral of x divided by x squared plus 4 plus 5 times the integral of 1 divided by x squared plus 4. Now looking at this first integral, this does fit the form of the integral of 1 over u du. Notice if we let u equal the denominator of x squared plus 4, then differential u, or du, is equal to 2x dx. Notice how we have x dx, so if we divide both sides by 2, we can say 1 half du equals x dx. Notice the second integral fits this form here, where the denominator would be a squared plus u squared, where a squared is our constant. So let's rewrite this as 4 plus x squared instead of x squared plus 4. In this form, we should recognize a squared equals 4, so a equals 2, and u squared equals x squared, so u is just equal to x. So if u is equal to x, then du equals dx, therefore no u substitution is required. Let's rewrite this first integral in terms of u. We'd have 4 times the integral of, our denominator would just be u, and then x dx is equal to 1 half du. We'll factor out the 1 half, and we have 1 du here. And now for the second integral, we'll just write this as plus 5 times the integral of 1 divided by, if we want, we can write 4 as 2 squared, and plus x squared. And now we can integrate. This will be 2 times the integral of 1 over u du. That'd be natural log absolute value plus c, or natural log. We don't need the absolute value though, because x squared plus 4 is u, which would always be positive. So we just have x squared plus 4 plus c sub 1, our constant of integration. And then we have plus 5 times 1 over a, which would be 1 over 2 or 1 half, arctangent of u divided by a, which is x divided by 2, plus c, we'll call it plus c sub 2. Now let's go ahead and distribute. We'll have 2 natural log of x squared plus 4 plus 2 times c sub 1, which we'll come back to, plus 5 halves arctangent of x divided by 2 plus 5 times c sub 2. Well, 2 times c sub 1 and 5 times c sub 2 is just another constant. So if we let c equal 2 times c sub 1 plus 5 times c sub 2, we can just put plus c here. This would be our antiderivative. I hope you found this helpful.